Hi friends! So, I am here to start another video. Today is another NetGalley manga reading vlog. I hope you guys are excited because I am so excited to talk to you about all of these titles. So, let's talk about what we're going to be reading today and then we'll get into actually reading them. So there's a total of 8 titles that we'll be reading in this vlog. So the first one I'm going to be reading is Boys Run the Riot. I believe this is... It's volume 1, obviously, but I believe it's a transgender manga, which outside of The Bride Was a Boy, I've not really seen. And I have all the buzz around this one is amazing, so I'm really excited to read this first volume. And then I have a pile from Viz. I love working with Viz so much. So I have volume 44 of Haikyuu. Y'all know me and my love of Haikyuu. I'm just excited to reread it. And then I've got Yakuza Lover volume 1, which... We're thriving on Yakuza Lover. Like, this is supposed to be, obviously, Yakuza arranged marriage kind of situation, I believe is how it goes. I don't remember for 100% sure, but all I know is I've heard it's smutty to the hills and I'm excited. The next one I have is Way of the House Husband Volume 5. I've been kind of feeling lukewarm about the series, so I wanted to try reading the arc before I decide if I'm going to continue purchasing the series because I just don't know where I'm going to feel. I have not tried the anime yet. I'm hoping to give that a watch sometime soon. So I'll give you my thoughts on that when I have it. And then I have Beastars Volume 12, which y'all know me and Beastars. It's once I got like fully invested in the series, like it's been nonstop. I've just loved every volume. And then I had The King's Beast Volume 2, which I'm super excited about. Oh my goodness. I loved Volume 1. I cannot wait to dive into Volume 2. And then I've got Love Me, Love Me Not Volume 8. Again, a series I continue to love and adore. And then last but not least, I have Fly Me to the Moon Volume 5. Again, another series I just love and adore. We're going to be reading some favorites here. We're going to be reading some new things. And let's go, let's go, let's go. Okay, so I just finished Boys Run the Riot Volume 1, and this story is about Watari, and Watari is transgender. They were born a female, but they feel like a male inside. And so we're dealing with the prejudices and the complications of life, especially in Japan, for Watari. And all of a sudden, this guy shows up at school named Jin. And Jin... is, you know, technically a third year, but he's repeating the second year because he missed so much school. And something happened. His friends have alluded to it, but we don't know what that is yet. Through that, Jin wants to start a fashion brand. And as Watari is dressed as themselves, out shopping, Watari and Jin reach for the same shirt, and Jin believes it's fate, and so he asks Watari to join him in, like, doing this brand together, and then they find somebody in the photography club who, again, feels on the outside, and the whole point of this brand is to kind of break societal norms, and they come up with the name for the brand right at the end of the volume, and the way that all happened was really fun, and this is going to be a very powerful series, I can already tell. This is going to be a really important piece for manga readers. I think a lot of people will feel seen. I think we're going to get some really interesting characters in the next volume from what I was seeing, and I'm very, very invested in the series. So very much looking forward to this really important transgender LGBT kind of manga, and I think we're going to be dealing with all sorts of different societal norms and being different and not following traditional society things, and it's going to be amazing. I'm really looking forward to the journey that's going to be this series. So yes, highly recommend Boys Run the Riot. This will be releasing, I believe it is going to release physically as well in May. I'll correct myself in down below or cut this part out if that's incorrect, but I'm very much looking forward to more in this series. So, time to move on. Okay, I have a new obsession. It's official, and it's Yakuza Lover. This is my new Fire in His Fingertips. This series will definitely be scratching that itch until we get the next volume of Fire in His Fingertips. In this one, we're following a 20-year-old woman. She wants to find a boyfriend, but she's very aggressive. She doesn't like these guys who are just like pandering around to her. And all of a sudden, she sees this guy like breaking up this like drug thing that she accidentally got pulled into. And the way she was standing up for herself was very attractive to him. So he gives her his card. And of course, he's this big like Yakuza boss. And he's very well known in the underworld and things. And from there, they start a romantic relationship that they're both very, very into. I mean, like, the first time they're together, he's eating her out. Like, I love this manga. I love it so much because, like, they go long periods without seeing each other because of the nature of his work to protect her. He doesn't have her out and about all the time with him because he wants to keep her safe and kind of out of his underworld public eye, I guess you could say. So anytime he can find time for her, she's like obsessed and goes right to him, and they spend their sexy time together. And oh lordy, like, it's steamy, it's fun, it's like steamy and sweet at the same time. So it has this really like almost like innocent sweet side to it, while also being wrapped up in all of the Yakuza politics and the sexiness, and I'm obsessed. That's all I can say is I am obsessed with this. It is everything. I love it. I love it so much. I love it way more than I should, if I'm honest. But I don't even care. Like, it is just, oh my goodness. It is just everything. And so when this comes out, I will be screaming about it forever. Like, I'm already screaming about it. Like, I messaged a bunch of my friends before I came to film this clip because I'm obsessed. Like, literally obsessed. I kind of want to just, like, reread it right now. But there are lines, like, he's talking, like, it's before they've ever, like, had sex. But he's like, the next time I see you, I'm going to kiss you so hard, like you're quaking inside. Your insides quake, I think is what it says exactly. And I'm obsessed with him. I love him. I love her. I love them. Yes, she is a Yakuza queen. She can stand up for herself and I love her for it. But he is definitely a Yakuza king as well. And I'm obsessed with them. Comparing this to like Boss Wife, which is a Yakuza title from Kodansha, I prefer Yakuza Lover because it's sexier to me. Like, I really like their dynamic better than I like the boss wife dynamic, if I'm honest. But I still like them both. Don't get me wrong here. But yes, just know that if you're going to compare the two, Yakuza Lover will win. So, yes. Anyways, moving on. Hi, yes, I did change. I'm actually going out to lunch with a friend. I'm just here at the ramen shop that we're gonna eat at. Anyways, I did just finish, while I was waiting for her to show up, volume 5 of Fly Me to the Moon. This one pretty much wraps up what happened in the anime. So if you've watched the anime, basically volumes 1 through 5 cover everything. I mean, I think there was like one chapter that was kind of a random in the middle that wasn't in the anime, but it's like, it might be in season 2, I don't know. But anyways, I really just love the sweetness of the story in the series. And it's a series I'm going to continue to recommend because I think it's really sweet and the way it's approaching everything is really a lot of fun. So I think there's a lot of fun to be had with this particular series. Okay, so I did also quickly get Haikyuu Volume 44 done. I am so excited to be coming to the conclusion of this series, like, in physical print. It's so good. It's one of my all-time favorites. It's probably the only sports shonen you will ever see me loving, and that's okay with me.
it's so character driven rather than sports driven that it's really hard to ignore. And I love it with so much of my being. It's not even funny. Those videos I keep talking about that I'm going to do about Haikyuu, I promise they're still coming. I just have to get over my own insecurities with them and actually upload them. So anyways, they are coming, but I love this series with so much of me that it's not even funny. Anyways.
What do you want to say to the people, sir? Are you being needy today? Okay, so I'm home. I changed back into my comfy shirt. And I just finished volume 8 of Love Me, Love Me Not. This volume was so precious and cute. We're seeing a lot of progress. Obviously, with Ryo and Yuna, we're getting progress. But we're also getting progress with Akari and Inui. And Christmas happens, and that was all adorable. Like, it just made my heart so happy. I was grinning through most of the volume. But we also have this discussion of parents fighting in the background and how that's affecting the kids. And I think that was a really nice addition to the story because obviously Ryo and Akari, like their parents, they're fighting because of, you know, Akari's mom has some habits. Dad's calling her on the habits, and so they're fighting about it. But, you know, then we get why Inui's parents are fighting, and it's because his older brother made decisions that they didn't approve of. And I think culturally, that's just a really interesting take. And so I really enjoyed this particular volume. I feel like it added a lot of depth to the story. Now that Ryo's kind of over his stuff, we needed that extra layer of depth going on in the story. And so now we're getting that. And I think that's what's going to get us through to the end of the series because it's a 12-volume series and this is volume 8. So we've got 4 more after this. And I really like what's happening. I like the direction. I see all 4 of them being family all together. But, you know, Ryo and Yuna married and then Akari and Inui married. Like, that's how I see this happening. I hope that that's how it goes. But either way, I really love the series, and I hope you guys jump into it if you haven't yet, because it's a lot of fun. I just finished volume 5 of The Way of the House Husband, and I think I'm dropping the series. I mean, it's fine. There's not anything necessarily wrong with it, but I'm just kind of bored with it. And, you know, even, like, only reading the volumes as they come out, I'm not itching for the next volume. I just think I'm done with this one. I have enough series that I collect that this is just one that I think needs to not be part of my collection anymore. Like, it's fun. A lot of people will love it. It's just, after the first couple volumes, I feel like it's the same joke over and over again. So it's not really working for me. Just like one of my favorites, Komi, doesn't work for a lot of people the further into the series it gets. So, you know, there are a lot of people out there who are going to love this. But, you know, it did some really fun things, but it's just not a series I care about anymore. Alrighty, so I just finished volume 2 of The King's Beast. And with this series, this particular volume, what it did is it solidified the relationship between Rangetsu and their prince. But from there, what happens is Rangetsu basically ends up befriending the first prince in helping him. He's kind of sickly and doesn't run his domain the same as the other princes. So what it does is they form a friendship because she kind of helps wake him up to what he can do, even when he feels like his hands are tied. Between Rangetsu and her prince, Tenyu, they're able to help the first prince save lives while also still doing their duty. So it's really interesting. I really loved it. It was really a good time. And I am so looking forward to the future of this series. This whole kingdom and the politicking going on is so interesting to me. And I really love the way Tenyu proved to Rangetsu that trust is had between the two of them. It just
was so well handled. I just love Raytoma. I love their storytelling so much. I'm starting to get a cold sore, guys. It sucks. But either way, I really love the series and highly recommend checking it out. Also, if you have not read Dawn of the Arcana, it is so good. Please read it. I plan on rereading again soon because I love the series so much.
And finally, for this particular vlog, we have Beastars Volume 12. In this one, we're seeing the ramifications of what happened in Volume 11. And I do like that there are actual consequences for Legoshi and Luis both in their own way for what happened in Volume 11. I can't tell you specifically because major spoilers. But because of that, there are very strict things. We see Legoshi get reunited with his grandfather and get a full understanding of that. And there is a new character introduced that I absolutely love and adore. I'm really excited to see how that character plays into the rest of the story. I mean, we're really kind of in the halfway point of this series now. And so it's just, I love the new characters that we're getting to know better because I think that's really going to be like the whole thing moving forward from here. So I'm really, really excited. And with that said, those are all of the volumes from NetGalley that I've read recently. Let me know in the comments down below what series you're excited for or series that you're excited for the next volume of. And if you're not really excited for anything or you're just here because you love me, why don't you do a sunshine? It's a beautiful sunshiny day, so anything with a sun in it is a great emoji to put. All right, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.